r/AskReddit. Parents of Reddit, why are you disappointed in your adult child? I'm not disappointed in my 18-year-old, but I sure wish I knew how to activate him. He graduated in May, has no desire to go to college and no real aspirations at all. He's pretty much been in his room on his phone since. He's struggled for many years with anxiety, which we're treating, and I know a lot of things are difficult for him. But man, I wish I knew how to get him excited about something, anything, whether it's a job or a hobby or a plan or whatever. At 18, I was exactly the same. Didn't really care about anything. Certainly didn't feel like an adult. I'm just shy of 23 now, and I did come out of it, slowly and painfully, at the same time. Not everyone I know did. Some of my friends are in exactly the same place they were at the end of high school, except that they go to a job instead of school. So you can't just sit back and hope he figures it out either. I'd suggest helping him cultivate a healthy personal life more so than pushing him to start making money honestly. Hobbies are a great help, especially if they push him to be a little more social. I spent absurd amounts of time as a teen holed up in my room with my guitar, and that skill eventually led to me branching out and meeting people at jam sessions. You sound just like my friend. After high school he just sort of stopped doing anything. I've tried for years to get him to do something, but he just won't. He just sits in his room and plays video games all day. His mom convinced him to go to college, but he dropped out after the first semester. I just don't know what to do. He doesn't seem motivated to do anything but play video games. We're 25 now, almost 26, and I don't want him to wake up one morning feeling like life passed him by. Any suggestions as to how I can help him? Unfortunately, there isn't much anyone can do sometimes. I was in a similar situation. No motivation or ambition. Played video games all day and night from like 15 to 30 years old, and I had family trying to help me and motivate me, but I didn't want to hear any of it. The only thing that got me to change my life was me deciding that I wanted to. Like the saying goes, you can lead a horse to water but you can't make it drink. I thought I'd share this too in case it helps anyone. I suffer from depression and suicidal thoughts, receiving treatment, so it's about more than just wanting to do something. When it was untreated, my depression was so bad that I basically didn't exist other than being a gamer tag on Xbox Live because I didn't feel like doing anything else and I didn't know how to explain it. I still have difficulty, so I kept it all to myself. On the outside you'd see an intelligent person wasting their life and it would seem so simple to fix. But on the inside it was pure chaos and it was overwhelming to the point where I had no hope of getting better. Additionally, I'm transgender and, until I started receiving treatment recently, have never felt comfortable in my own skin. I still don't, but I'm making progress. So I always isolated myself and kept everyone, including, perhaps especially, family, at bay emotionally. I guess what I'm saying is talk to your friend and find out if there's anything deeper going on with them. Maybe they are miserable and just biding their time until they die. Or maybe they are overwhelmed by the big disgusting world outside and don't know where to begin. My TLDR is basically this. You can only do so much for someone, but at the end of the day they have to want it for it to matter. No drive, no ambition, and no work ethic worth a damn. He's 25. He peaked in 6th grade. Hi mom. She even got my age wrong. And we don't even call it 6th grade in my country. My mum's disappointed that I left a £33,000 a year job for a £28,000 job because I had 2 mental breakdowns. Even though everything is now perfect. Sometimes we just have to get on with it. Your mental health is worth way more than £5,000 a year. As long as you have enough to get by, you made the right call. Ha, same here. Recently changed jobs for my mental health. I'm disappointed in my son because he is too much like me. He's a solid introvert who is afraid to ask for help and doesn't want to bother people, even with very legitimate requests. He is an expert procrastinator. I remember being that age and being so much like that. I'm not sure how I got through university, but I've been a successful engineer for 30 years, so I've still got a lot of hope for him. Also, both my kids vape smoke. We've been anti-smokers for all our adult lives and I'm sad to see them choose to do something negative like that. They both want to quit, but it's a tough road. Dude, hop on that right now. I had the same issues and it led to me failing out of school, drinking and a suicide attempt. All at age 20, I wasn't confronting my fear of asking people for help and it was eating me alive. The only thing that snapped me out of it was actually failing out of school and needing to tell my parents. Then it was 2-3 solid years of therapy and stuff like that. Seriously, you gotta get in there and see if he really needs the help I needed. He isn't even looking for a job or to get out of the house. He just eats my food without paying a penny and watches TV or plays all day. 2-year-olds are so entitled. Had us in the first half. My mom is extremely disappointed with me because I'm not having kids. It was my sole purpose in life. Good for you. I ended up with kids. But after 7 years of getting to know and enjoy being with my wife, I fully support anyone who doesn't want kids. It's important to be for you and not someone else. My stepmom never wanted kids, and when she told her parents that at the age of 25, her mother responded in a rather humorous way, "At least tell me you will have pets." She later married my mom when she was in her mid-40s and had me as her stepdaughter. Even though she never wanted to be a mom, she's a great stepmom. And yes, we had 2 cats and a dog. My son is 25 and was diagnosed with bipolar disorder at around 15 years old, maybe younger. After he became too old and too big for me to manage his meds, he refused to take them and his life has been a roller coaster of disasters ever since. Between prison time, juvie and adult, bad decisions, suicidal ideation, drug use, fathering 2 children he doesn't see, same mom, and insisting on making up reasons to not speak to me, I'm done. Because honestly, there's nothing I can do for him. At this point, I'm just waiting to get a phone call on where I need to go to identify the body. He is in prison for life. Could you tell us what he did, if you are comfortable with it? Killed 2 people. That sucks. Especially for the victims. That guy must have totally ruined their day. Ah, and here you have a very good example what not to say to a parent whose kid has killed 2 people. My parents are disappointed in me because I won't pretend I wasn't damaged from their abuse. My dad does this annoying thing where he acts clueless as to why his kids are weird or why we don't talk to him like a normal child would. IDK man. Maybe being beaten and berated for your whole childhood makes you weird. This reminds me a lot of my dad and I's relationship. He was verbally abusive and never hesitated to let me know having kids ruined his life, and he regretted being talked into it. He chilled out after we were adults, but my brother and I could never really build a relationship once he calmed down. At one Thanksgiving, he sat us down and asked point blank why that was, and we both said we resented him and couldn't just turn that off. He ended up killing himself when I was 25. That was 10 years ago, and I don't know if it's the time removed or if I've matured, but I feel like now that I have the wife, kids, and job with all the trappings, we could finally relate and bro down. I'm over the shitty relationship we had. I want his advice now, but he didn't stick it out long enough for me to come around. Not sure what my point is really. I guess, make an effort while you have a chance. My ex-husband was the son that my parents wanted their actual son to be. So they're pissed that my brother isn't like him, and they're pissed that I divorced him. Double whammy. Never mind that we just fundamentally did not work as a couple. They basically see it as me stealing away their chance at having the perfect child in a son-in-law. Oh well. What made him so special? He has a really nice job and he's generally just a very outgoing person. Total extrovert. My brother and I don't have the personalities to sit and chat up everyone at the family reunion for 6 straight hours like the ex does. I have a nice job, but not like everyone who's when they hear it nice. And my brother's gone through a lot of shit and is really struggling, so they have very little exciting news about him to share with their friends. He got a $200,000 inheritance when his father passed away 2 years ago. He is broke now. Did he do any good with the money? Any assets to show for it? Any chance there was a Montgomery Brewster style clause in the will? He put $80,000 on a down payment on a house, and the rest in stocks, which he lost. Can't blame you. Mental health is everything when it comes to a stable life. Being happy is something that more people should prioritize. My dad always told me, "I don't care if you dig ditches as your career, as long as you are happy doing it." I'm taking some risks now to try and do what will make myself happy in the future, and I have not looked back. Reading this has strengthened my resolve to do what makes me happy. I sincerely hope you have a happy life. My mom held getting a degree as one of the pinnacle achievements you can do because it was such a big deal to her going back to school and getting her degree in her 40s. As someone who works in IT, I dropped out about a year into school and haven't looked back. That was 10 years ago. I hid that I dropped out for many years before I actually told her. She was disappointed. But in my opinion, the astronomical cost of a degree does not have a good ROI, and in IT, I've worked up to a very high salary level without one. Certifications, mentors, learning on the job and at home. To me, a 4-year degree doesn't make much logical sense in a fast-moving field like this one. Think there will ever be a time when a degree would be required? Back in the day, my pops apparently worked for Fox as an accountant and he got a couple of his friends' jobs with him. They were incredibly brilliant and worked hard, they just didn't have the degree. After a management change, they asked everyone to present theirs and they all got let go, so that always worries me about the IT field. Like, it may not be needed now, but down the line it might. Then again, I know nothing about how your career works. He is 24 years old and has a full-blown meth addiction that started in the last 6 months. He was fired from the job he got at 18 because he was high and manic. Sidebar, his manager was the one that introduced him to meth. Since then, he has dedicated his time to either finding or using meth. He has been arrested 3 times, spent 30 days in jail, and continues to use even though he is on probation. He is angry because we will not allow him to live with us while he is using. He is now homeless. He broke into our house and stole some of his father's sports memorabilia to support his habit. Some of it is not replaceable and very sentimental. He is a shell of the human we knew 6 months ago, both figurative and literally. He cannot hold a normal conversation and is constantly twitching. We have offered to get him help, but he is convinced that the drugs have set him free and we all are living in a delusional world where we have to work and conform to society. It is killing us. On the other hand, our daughter, 23, just graduated college in June with a paralegal degree and has decided to go to law school. She is afraid to celebrate her success because she doesn't want to make him feel bad or upset him. But duck him for taking that away from her. Poor girl. Celebrate her. Don't let her sideline her accomplishments. I'm 2 years older than my brother, and I completed 2 university degrees in 6 years before he managed to pass his high school equivalency exam. I never felt close to him, so it never occurred to me to minimize my accomplishments in order to help him feel like less of a shit. I took a backseat to him and his needs my entire childhood, and understood why it needed to be that way. But as an adult, I didn't hold anything back when it came to worrying about how he'd feel about my accomplishments compared to his lack thereof. Don't let your daughter minimize herself to make him appear bigger. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.